Stand on Mayor Perez's comments. The state had done their job and locked up Ezekiel Roberts. He believed the shooting would have happened, so he think he was the target, and the rest were
individuals. Ezekiel Roberts is one of the targets. One of the news we looked at as having licensed to use firearms for part of what we call one of the street gangs, which is we believe money to being bedrock. He was associated with that particular organization. And yes, we believe had he been arrested, this may not have occurred.
How many
tips
have you been hearing from the community since
that? We received a lot of phone calls, a lot of information. We still encourage people to call, so we want to follow what we need to get. But Ezekiel Roberts is one example of what happens to individuals who should be locked up out on the street. Don't forget, he was incarcerated. Had he been incarcerated, he may be alive today, or maybe that would happen on Saturday, because he was on probation 12 years suspended, six by probation for a stab incident that occurred a year ago. So he was on probation as of March 8th. He was arrested three times after that. He should not have been on the street.
Chief,
for clarification,
Hartford said that he was just a member of the district. That's correct. Could you talk a little bit, Chief, about the gang activity in the city? I didn't hear what you said. He was a member of...
The landscape is very simple. These are young individuals who are not structured like gangs in Atlanta. Most of these are young teenagers between the ages of, say, 13 and 19 years old. And unfortunately, they're not in the system as of yet because they're young. Unfortunately, they're getting younger and younger. They have a propensity to use firearms. So they're loosely connected. Some of them are two-block raiders, they know each other. Their family members shooting other family members. So they're not what we call really hardcore gangs. It's groups who live in the same neighborhood and kind of just doing a violent thing.
Is it turf battles or is it drug-related or
a combination of the two, and not also a combination of what I call disrespect. They feel disrespected, then instead of trying to resolve what we normally would, they use firearms.